power ports as well. And then if we take a look on the other side, you've got your, on this side, I'm sorry, is your power button. And down here on the other side is your plus and minus. So today I'm going to give you the top 10 features I found that I liked about this Xplore R12 tablet. It was also made by Motion, sometimes called Motion or Zebra. It's the R12 model. This one, particular one, has an i5 processor. And of course, you could get it with the i7 when you were buying it brand new. But these are my top 10 features I like the most with it. So number 10, came in at number 10, is all the ports. So this thing, if you look right here, you open up the port cover, you have a USB 3.0, an HDMI out, an SD card reader right here. Not bad. This is your port cover, and then right here is your power ports as well. And then if we take a look on the other side, you've got your, on this side, I'm sorry, is your power button. And down here on the other side is your plus and minus, so you can increase the volume or decrease the volume using these buttons over here. So overall, it's got what you expect in a tablet. So that's my number 10 feature. Number nine is the touchscreen. The touchscreen is a 10-point capacitive touch. It's not bad, up to date, I like it. Number nine is how thin this tablet is. It's thinner than its competition, the FZG1 or even the GTAC F110. It's 0.65 inches thick, which is not bad. So I kind of like how thin it is. Number seven is how much it weighs. This little tablet only weighs 2.9 pounds. Much lighter, a little bit lighter than your FZG1 and a little lighter than your F110, so I like it. Although it has the bigger screen, somehow they've made it a little bit lighter. The other thing is, to give you an idea of the size, this screen, you know, for the size tablet, I like a larger tablet, but the screen size on this, so the size on this tablet is 0.65 inches thick, 12.9 inches long, 8.1 inches wide. So it's not bad for size wise. The screen's, like I said, a little bit bigger, so you're gonna have a bigger chassis. Number five, coming in at number five, is the fully high definition screen. This is a 1920 by 1080 megapixel screen, which comes in very, very clear. Number four item that I like, and not all of them have this, this is the hidden digital pin storage place. You can stow this pin right inside, it goes right into the chassis and disappears. It has this tether to hold it so you can't lose it, which is really a nice feature, but that's where the pin goes. I like it because it's just not clipped on. I hated those clip-on ones where you pop it on the side, those clips end up breaking, and then the pin doesn't stay and that sort of thing. Number three, it's a fully rugged rated IP54 tablet to military standard 810G. So what does that mean? Well, it's fully rugged. The IP rating, if you don't know what that means, the 5 and the 4, you need to go read my blog about IP ratings or watch my video where I explain what IP ratings are. I'll leave the links to that information in the description. Number two, best feature, almost the best feature, second best feature, is the fan vent cover. It's specially designed to help cool the tablet, as well as it is water resistant so it can keep its IP rating. That to me is better than its competition to boot, because now you don't have the heat coming off this unit. It's the heat's being dissipated. That's really, really nice. The other option on this, which I found very interesting, and it's of course my number one feature, is the battery. The battery is a hot swappable battery. So you can pull this battery out after it, you know, after a while of using it and it, you know, you need to change it or charge it. You can pop a brand new battery in. You'd need two batteries for this, but you can pop the new battery in. Boom, you're still working. the laptop never shuts off. So it's a hot swappable battery, which I found to be really nice. Now, you know, I promised you guys some bonus material here. And with the bonus material, this of course has Wi-Fi, it has Bluetooth. This particular model got the option of the fingerprint reader, which is right here. You can scan your fingerprint and do those sort of things. Really nice tablet. Don't see any problems with it. I think I've got you all the features that I could think of and find on this thing. So I'll see you guys next week.